रिकॉर्डिंग चालू झाले. हॅलो
हेलो
गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ साइबर फॉर द एफडीपी. इट इज माय इमेंस प्लेजर टू इंट्रोड्यूस टुडेज रिसोर्स पर्सन प्रोफेसर गौतम मधुकर माने. सर इज वर्किंग इन द बीटी कॉलेज कोल्हापूर. प्रीवियसली वॉज वर्किंग इन द Government College of Education, Ratnagiri. Today we are lucky to have him for the second session and hope sir will deliver his thoughts on the topic models of teaching. The time given to sir is 10:30 to 12, but due to some technical issues we are starting a bit late, and last 15 minutes we'll reserve for the question and answer session. You can fire your questions in the text, or you can just directly ask to sir. I hope sir will handle the question answer, and I will be there to talk about academic qualifications of the Mane sir. He has completed his post graduation in English and MEd, has completed his MPhil, and is qualified set in education as such. He belongs to the Department of Higher and Technical Education and is having professional experience of around 20 years. His fields of specializations and subjects what he deals in his academics are educational philosophy, environmental education, which is demand of a day, and English methodology. Sir is having vast experience. I hope all the participants will take advantage of this. And sir has authored so many books, and his instruction material and reading material is included in the school syllabus books and journals, and it is referred books recommended by the printed university syllabus copy. Additional resources sir has provided by using internet websites and magazines. Sir has completed so many training programs, faculty development programs to name few. Sir is involved in the revision of the syllabus of English standard 7th at state level. Sir has completed special refresher training program conducted by the Yashoda at state level. Field teacher CLHRD at the national level by a Department of Technology, has completed bridge course, Department of Education, university level, sir has done. Then if you see the administrative experience or institutional governance responsibility, sir has performed so many things to name few. Sir has worked as a rector in the Government College of Education, Ratnagiri, and NAC IQAC coordinator during the tenure of September 2006 to March 2015. Again at the Government College of Education. Sir has authored few books to name few. Shikshak Honyasati, it is for the B.Ed. students. It gives the information regarding the CET, and it is published by the Phadke Prakashan. The other book is Teacher Education in the Present Scenario. It is edited by the Mrs. Kaur and Mrs. Gupta Kauri. It is published by the Kasturi Lal and Sons, Amritsar, Punjab. The book bears the ISBN number. With this brief introduction to sir, I don't want to be hurdle in between you and sir. I'll request Mane sir to take over and go ahead with the topic models of teaching. Over to you, sir.
Introduction by such a very experienced local scholar
silence. Okay. So it's my so today we begin our topic, which is quite popular since last year, about 2 decades. The topic which is necessary for all the teachers, right from KG to PG, at university, such a guidance, they consider this one as the most effective part of teaching, even if it's most innovative one also, because it is founded in military campaign. And for teaching particular campaign, what type of a methodology we should have is this map. Then we find the origin of models of teaching by actually the author is from Arvind. So this book has quite systematically designed connection. If we consider that the education program, the models are teaching about more part of that, and today we discuss about the models of teaching.
Sir, off mute, so mute. Hey, kindly unmute yourself.
Unmute.
Please unmute. Unmute. Speaker is muted.
Your friend, sir, point to speaker. This is Amit Pandit. Sir, I am unmute. Sir. அவங்களுக்கு ஏதாவது ரிஜிவன் வாங்கிட்டு கேட்டாரு. ஆமா, நாங்க ஒரு பேக் வாங்கினோம் 1000 ரூபாய்க்கு. அது வந்து விசாரிச்சுக்க தரீங்களா சார் சொன்னேன். பஸ் ஸ்டாண்டுக்கு போற வழியில்தான் இருக்குன்னு. சரி மேம், டீட்டெயில் அனுப்புங்கன்னாங்க. அது வந்து உங்ககிட்ட அந்த ரெசிப்ட் இருக்குல்ல, அது கூட நான் போட்டோ எடுத்தாலும் அனுப்பி
விடுறேன்.
உங்கதான் இருக்குன்னு பாத்து 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 போடுமே.
மார்னிங்
हेलो
हेलो हेलो सर गुड मॉर्निंग
एम आई ऑडिबल
यस सर यू आर ऑडिबल
मॉडल्स ऑफ टीचिंग इमर्ज्ड आउट ऑफ द सर्च बाय ब्रूस जॉयस एंड मार्शा वेल टू फाइंड अ वैरायटी ऑफ अप्रोचेस एंड स्ट्रेटजीज ऑफ टीचिंग टू मैच द वेरियस लर्निंग स्टाइल्स. So just we consider about the, what do you mean by approach? What do you mean by technique? What do you mean by method? And what do you mean by model? So approach is a point of view. As according to the many, we have a point of views. So point of view signify some approaches are teacher-centered approaches. Actually, what David Asubil has mentioned in his advance organizer, that approach is a teacher-centered approach. So there is a constructivist approach to teaching, collaborative approach to teaching, individualistic approach to teaching. So variety of approaches are there. And when we consider about the method, other than this particular point of view, we have a method for direct method, GT method, excursion method, generally our lecture method. So method is a set of teaching techniques which is a planned procedure, and then we have a strategies of teaching, strategies, way of teaching where it matches various learning styles to find the solution to dilemma of different learning styles. So perplexing situation inside the classroom, how can we overcome with the help of this teaching, so a set of teaching techniques, that is the to help the pupil, to help the student to learn that particular content. Variety of strategies developed by different learning theories and designed a number of models of teaching. So actually we have 22 models of teaching. Just today we are going to focus on that. When we consider the definition of model of teaching, models of teaching, then first try to understand, define the definition. What do you mean by definition? When we prepare any definition, that is not mere a meaning. What do you mean by definition? Definition means, that is the definition of definition. Definition is an explicit statement of entire quotation of a term. So explicitly it should be clear in that definition. So this is the, this is defined definition of definition. If we consider about the models of teaching, then it has, I have highlighted on this PPT, three definitions are there. One, teaching model is a pattern or plan. Even we have a, in method also we have a plan, but it is not a pattern, pattern at all, which can be used to shape a curriculum. We know the difference between curriculum and syllabus, syllabus. Curriculum is a wider term and syllabus for particular, designed for particular class, a course to select instructional material and to guide a teacher's teacher's actions. So teacher's actions are being guided with a planned pattern is called model, specific model of teaching. That is the defined term by Bruce Joyce and Marsha Bell. Then models are perspective teaching strategies designed to accomplish particular instructional goals. So this definition signifies the perspective teaching strategies which are designed to accomplish a particular instructional goal. We have the instructional goals which are predefined, and how we achieve that by setting the strategies is called a model. So it is on paper, we accomplish it and then execute it. Models of teaching consists of guidelines for designing educational activities and environments. So one another word here added related to educational activities, classroom atmosphere. So if we charged ourselves along with the classroom atmosphere, then the result, the outcome of our teaching gets better. So model signifies that the specific way of teaching and learning that are intended to achieve in a certain kinds of a goals. So this is of and about definition. Characteristics of models of teaching. So if we see the characteristics, one is teaching strategies. It has a strategy to achieve the specific goals. It has a separate guidelines for each and every lesson. It has the perspective plan, which is may not be inside the pedagogy. Pedagogy have a many subject, some social sciences, languages, literature, so sociology and mathematics. So pedagogical subjects are different. Perspective subject, which is a core subject, which define what is in that particular subject. So perspective and pedagogy, here models of teaching define the perspective. Realization of objectives means we have the objective, but how can we realize with our planned program, which pattern we are going to resolve that particular, for that particular content is the realization of inside the realization of our objective. It has the instructional procedure, means it is not always teacher centered. It has some set of instruction and it is instructional. It has a specific instruction. Then it's a scientific inquiry. It is not only a scientific process procedure. It has a scientific inquiry. How can we achieve that in a very logical manner? So specification of environment is a part of that. That is the classroom atmosphere. If we try to achieve the well-planned classroom atmosphere, then we achieve what we want to achieve, that is the realization of objective. Bruce Joyce and Marsha Bell, when they define the models of teaching, it has the four families of models of teaching. First one is a information processing family. Second one is a personal family. Some models are related to the personal family. Another one is social interaction family. And last one is a behavior modification family. So four families are there. And as according to need of the content, we choose that particular family. Inside in that, the motive, the title is there. The procedure is mentioned there. We put our content in that and then we form the model. For example, there is an information processing family. In that, this model helps learner to seek a master information, organize it, build and test the hypothesis. Here, master the information means we have the rudimentary data, and how can we master the information? How can we well organize, build it, and testing the hypothesis means it is a tentative assumption which is drawn from our rudimentary data, that is the hypothesis. So in this information processing family, how to work on rudimentary data to reach up to the research based results, that is the findings. So this family signifies the master information, organized it, build it, and testing the hypothesis. Then concerned with intellectual skills and acquisition of a knowledge by student, we have the inductive thinking model. Hilda Taba has wrote that concept attainment model and advanced organizer model by David Asube. So it has more than six, but just for the sake of example, here we have put here, considered with intellectual skill and acquisition of a knowledge means how we acquire the knowledge with a concern with intellectual skills. So student use their skills to getting the knowledge by using these particular models, that is inductive thinking model. The word inductive itself signifies induce. Induct means not deduct. Inductive means ex rule or rule. First there is an example and then there is a rule, that is inductive. And deductive means first there is a rule and then there is an example, rule. So in inductive thinking, it gives always a new knowledge. So it's a method of discovery. In another word, inductive means it's a method of discovery. Actually, when we discover it, it is a method of learning. Naturally, it's a method of teaching. So child acquires first-hand knowledge and information by actual observation. So observatory part is a core of in inductive. It's a slow process actually. Inductive process is a slow one. It trains the mind and gives self-confidence and initiative. It trains the mind of the pupil, and it gives the initiation. Students are fully active in inductive thinking model because they find the rule by various examples. It is an upward process thought and leads to the principles. Means there is a difference between rule and principle. Every rule have any exception, but principle doesn't have any. So first there is a rule, above that rule there is a principle. So this is the inductive thinking process, and induction creates a new knowledge, creation of a knowledge. That is the one maxim of teaching we cover here, from known to unknown. What we know and then leads up to unknown, that is the maxim of teaching also covered here in information processing family, inductive thinking. Then how we attain the concept? It has the steps. In a next slide, it will be percolated in that. So in a second one family, personal family, stresses on personal development of individual, individualistic development. So more concerned with human feelings and emotion. So non-directive classroom meeting and desensitization, all that it is included in personal family, upliftment of individual. So that is the personal development of an individual. Then we have a social interaction family, emphasize the development of capability of interpersonal relationship. That is the development of social skill, our social behavior. So group investigation, laboratory method, role playing, the invented by Fanny Schaffel, and simulation. So all that is in a social interaction. Behavioristic modification family are shaping behavior by manipulating stimulus, response, and reinforcement, that is encouragement or punishment, self-control, stress reduction, direct training model. So these are some examples for all or four families: information processing family, personal family, social interaction family, and behavior modification family. So if we consider this particular characteristics, these four family have specific characteristics. One is specification of learning outcome. Every teaching doesn't have, we have the evaluation, that is the summative evaluation at the end of our teaching, but every time it is not being mentioned the outcome. So perform instructional sequence and note the outcome at the very outset. That is the specification of learning outcome we have seen in the model of teaching. This is the newness of this particular model. Then specification on environment means student learn not by only classroom teaching, but classroom environment also helps them. So that's why we say the school atmosphere, the temple atmosphere, family atmosphere, atmosphere in bus station, railway station. So it has a newness, or it is different one. It has the, you get a reply to from that environment. So response specific environment is there. So school atmosphere or college atmosphere should be conducive one. Academic atmosphere should be there. So for that specification of environment, what type of a school atmosphere or conducive atmosphere expected, it is also mentioned in the model. So this is the one, another one characteristic of every model, that specification of they note the environment. Specification of criterion of performance. So it every model have a specific criteria. A model of teaching specifies the criterion for performance which is expected from the student. So there is a compulsive atmosphere that every student should actively participate in this in the notion which is prescribed by a particular model for the specific content. So criterion of performance is predefined in model of teaching. In general teaching or in general methodology, the criteria of performance is not being mentioned. For example, there is a lecture method, just teacher speak inside class, student just listen. They may be actively listen or they may be passively perform. They pretend to listen. All this is happening in actual teaching lecture method. But in specific model, the student should actively part and it is compulsory one. So every model is criterion of performance. And it should be qualified, otherwise the outcome will not see. Another one characteristic of every model is specification of operation. A model of teaching have a specified program of mechanism, how it works, that provides for the reaction of a student and interaction with the environment. What is the teacher's activity? What student's activity? What is the atmosphere expected? What is the teaching aid or the resource material he needed? What are the evaluation tools required for?
कनेक्शन गेलं होतं ना आता.
हॅलो. कन्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ अ करिक्युलम ऑर कंटेंट ऑफ अ कोर्स. सपोज आय लाईक टू कन्स्ट्रक्ट द सिलेबस ऑन फॉर सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट. यस रेडी. व्हॉट डू यू मीन बाय सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट? सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट इज द डेव्हलपमेंट विच मीट्स द नीड्स ऑफ प्रेझेंट जनरेशन without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their own needs. Means in a sustainable development, what we expect? In a sustainable development, we expect we meet the needs of a present generation without compromising the ability of a future generation to meet their own needs. So we preserve something, natural resources, for future also. So in a construction of a curriculum based on SD, sustainable development, it has the three dimension: social dimension, environmental dimension, economic dimensions. And for fulfilling that dimensions of SD, sustainable development, we have a sustainable development education program. How can we achieve in a future? So to preserve the needs of a future generation, and for the construction of that particular curriculum, we use the model, that is the use of models of teaching for enriching the content, and as according to the need of the situation, we give them the coursework. Then it helps in proper selection of instructional material for teaching and prepared course of the curriculum. Means not only the construction of a curriculum, but instructional material, training modules we develop with the help of models of teaching. Means there is a content and we have the how to taught that particular content for that particular standard or class. We prepare the instructional material with the help of models of teaching. Then it helps in designing appropriate educational activities. Educational activities are already there in the textbook. What should we do after completion of that? That is, the sessional works are there, but appropriate educational activities will get designed with the help of models of teaching. Then it assists procedure of material to create interesting and effective material and learning resources. So it assists the procedure of learning material to create interesting and effective material. So students should participate in such an activity which are more interesting for them, which they like them. So to create such an interesting activities, the learning resources we develop, and then the effective material helps to enrich the model. Then it stimulate the to find out the ways and means of creating environment, then interaction, teaching interaction. 1 minute. So designing appropriate educational activity, that is the use of, then effective materials and learning resources, information, the formation of theory of teaching. So each and every content is based on particular theory. It may be a behavioristic theory or constructivist approach. So based on particular theory, learning theory, every content is being developed and it is percolated inside the classroom. So models of teaching helps to develop a theory. Then we have four families: information processing family, that is the it has the stimuli environment, means some stimulus is there and the responses are there, it is being created in the classroom, then we have created an environment, educational environment in the classroom. Solution to the problem. So why we get information, the rudimentary data, then we have information to find the solution, remedial solution to the problem. To develop some verbal and non-verbal symbols. Some verbal and non-verbal symbols are there for processing particular information, and then encoding and decoding of data. It will happen and then we find the solution. Some merits of this particular model. It's natural way of teaching and learning. Why it is called a natural and not an artificial? Because they find how child learns, how student learns, what is the natural way of learning, as like a direct method of teaching. In before that, we learn a language by GT method, that is the grammar translation method, and we skip that. Why we skip that? Because every language should learn in its own origin. Means if I like to learn English, I should join to the Wales, Scotland, North Ireland, England, where the language is being born and brought up. Born actually, not a brought up. So Scotland, Wales and North Ireland, these are this is the land where English is born. So the original source of that particular language, if I learn there, join there and learn, then that is the natural way of learning. If I like to learn Marathi, then stay in a Maharashtra, speak, join to the Marathi speaker, leave their family, and you will naturally learn that particular language. It may be in a form of a communication, literature, language. So the natural way of learning any language is that you have to join to that particular ethos of speakers. So language is a species specific. Language is a acquired form. In that sense, we say language should be caught, not to be taught. So you have to code the language in a natural way. This model helps us to find the natural way of learning that particular notion or content. So it's a natural way. They find the natural way of learning. It is helpful in developing the power of imagination of a student. Imaginative power is such a matter where it is an actual manifestation of his own creation. Creativity means, the word creativity defines imaginative reconstruction of a reality. Means he has imagined himself well, and then he reconstructs in his mind and then form into the reality. That is the creativity. Means three steps are there. Imaginative reconstruction of reality, it's a fulfillment of curiosity, and there we find the invention. So model helps the power of imagination of the student. In our state, particular in Maharashtra, many of the textbook, they have the topic design your own test, create your own poem. So not only student gives the answer of a question which is formed by the teacher, or question they are drawn from the question bank, but design your own test. This unit signifies the imagination of a student. How can I design the test which is useful for myself to check the knowledge what I learn? It helps to think logically. So logical mathematical talent is being developed through these models. So it helps to develop the power of imagination of a student. Imagination is such a thing where I have one experience when in our university, Shivaji University, Kolhapur, 17 years back, in 2000, we have Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sahab was here for a convocation ceremony. And in a month of March, is a very hot season, summer season. And sir, in his speaking, the fan get off and whole pandal get having a hot temperature. Everybody is sweating and only microphone is on. So all AC and fans get closed and due to some electric problem, electrification problem. At that time, Kalam sahab has having the, I like to quote his sentence. If I brought the temperature of Delhi to here, then it is so comfortable for you and me also. Means at that time in Delhi, the temperature is quite near about cool one as compared to Kondapur due to some climatic changes. So the temperature transfer from one place to another, is it possible for us? Actually, it is not practically, it is practically impossible, but that is the imagination. That is the imaginative reconstruction. Such type of a thinking, we find the power of imagination of every student. Another example of which I like to quote here. One of my student asked us, sir, we have the blood group of A, B, AB and O. So that is the content which, as I am a teacher educator, our student taught in the class that four types of blood groups are there, A, B, AB and O. So one student asked us, sir, those people who are donor, means before that, the content signifies that the O blood group is the best donor and AB blood group is the best receiver. So best donor, he has imagining the image, he has the imagination that the people who are the best donor and find the charitable, founder of charitable trust, they all have the O blood group. What's your answer? The teacher, the student asked in the classroom, sir, the best donors, they form the charitable trust, they all have the O group, O blood group. What is the expected answer? Our teacher says, no, it is not like that. It is not related to that. Another one says, no, it is a matter of research. It's a matter of research. So such a power of imagination, such a power of imagination we inculcate through the models. It helps to develop the reasoning power. Reasoning, why it is happening? Reasoning power. So reasoning is a, it has the foundation of logical mathematical talent. If you are good in logic, then your reasoning ability will improve. And some logical models, how to, in information processing family, we have a reasoning power, how to heighten the reasoning power of the student. Then the students to analyze things systematically, it keeps student actively engaged in the classroom activity. Means if the students are only expect advanced organizer model, which is developed by David Asubil, excluding that, all the models have expected the active engagement of a student in the class. So if it is, if students are not actively engaged, then the merits of models of teaching won't work. So it has the failure. So in models of teaching, students should actively engage in the classroom activity. Models of teaching helps making the student good observation. Observation is a thing which is, which it has the steps of how to observe. Seeing one thing, an observation, careful observation, depiction, these two to three words are different in a notion. So observation, that quality will get improved in models of teaching, which it has the procedural planned format. So the student busy in the classroom works. Actually, they are active, so they are busy in the classroom work. Whether class or clash, I give the title, whether it's a classroom or classroom. Classroom, inside the classroom is the conducive atmosphere, and clash classroom, it has a negative notion of chaos, not a cosmos. Cosmetic, cosmos, conducive atmosphere, it is a positive element. Chaotic, many times students say, sir, I will say the answer and they are creating the chaos. It helps to getting the content, so it is not a classroom. But just a teacher are inside the classroom, he is speaking and all students are listening. I might not be say the passive listener. It is, I think, though you are looking the silence there, it is a clash in between his, means many times many students are pretending that they are carefully listening, but actually it won't happen. So whether it is a classroom or classroom, we put all the student in the same atmosphere for all the subject. That is the clash, one thing. Another one, we have a sequence of such a subject where the concentration, it deactivated. We have the one subject, history, then immediately another one teacher comes and taught geography. Then another one teacher having a mathematics. So accountancy, then history. In accountancy, we have a commission, and in history, we have a Simon Commission. So the clash between commission and Simon Commission, that is the clash, conceptual clash. So close this, open another one, close this, close your notebook, shut your mouth and close your notebook and book, listen to me. So such a 2 to 3 to 4 series of subject creates a many time a clash. So observation and concentration quality. So every day, not the model signifies every day, not more than 2 to 3 subject, two subject, more, not more than 2 subjects should be taught to the student. Otherwise it is not a classroom. It becomes a clash. Our Kothari Education Commission is having a very nice statement. The destiny of nation is being shaped in the classroom. Actually, I'm not agree with this sentence nowadays, because agree in the sense destiny of India nation is being shaped in the classroom, but many times the destiny of nation is being shaped outside the classroom also. There are many more things which students learn outside the classroom, and then they use that particular knowledge in the classroom also for subject enrichment. So in effective teaching, how can we use the classroom conducive atmosphere to shape the personality of a student inside the classroom, which they draw some knowledge from outside the classroom also. So models of teaching helps in this connection. Teaching aid is necessary for each period. That is the compulsive way, but teaching aid means not a PPT at all. PPT is a use of chalkboard. In good old days, teacher used chalkboard, and instead of that, we replace the media, that is the PowerPoint presentation. Means PPT is not a computer assisted instruction. So many time our student have generally says, and many time teacher says, that computer assisted teaching, CALL, computer assisted language learning, and inside in that teacher use the PPT, shows the PPT, and learning with computer, he qualified that word and use call it as a computer assisted learning. So it is not parallel to that. Some teaching aids, some relias are needed. The actual things, if it is possible, if teacher use that, then it is helpful for the student. Interaction is a core part of teaching. If students are listening silently, two things are more important in education, which I last day quote. The teacher should have an ability to teach. That is the one thing. And the second one, which is a prime one, because the teacher have the qualities and qualifications. He has completed post-graduation, then research degrees, some competitive exams, orientation program, refresher program, some summer vacation program, winter vacation program, FDPs, and all that is the required one. So teacher have the ability to teach by he is heightening all that. Another one part is that the student should have capacity to learn, or let's say I delete that particular word, capacity, withdraw that word and use willingness to learn. If student have the willingness, then the student-teacher interaction will happen in the classroom, and it is the beginning of effective teaching. So if we see any model of teaching out of 22 models, each and every model have specific 6 components. Each and every model have objective. Even each and every model have a, even method have a objective. Without objective, we can't enter into the class. If without objective we entered into the class, then we are our student get idiot and we himself called an idiot. Why I use that word idiot? Because there is one quotation in Sanskrit. Uddishta mano disham na mando api pravartane. Without objective, the idiots also can't move from one place to another. So without objective, the teaching methodology, techniques, strategies, approaches, and even model doesn't work. So objective is a what we like to achieve, why to learn, what to learn is a content, why to learn, that is the objective. And objective without objective, 1, 2, 3 definition objective we put in research also. We put an objective to analyze the unit and find out the environmental components reflected in it. Then we develop a strategy, prepare a pack of communication strategies for student or teacher. That is another one, second objective. And in a third one, we find the effectiveness of developed strategies and find the research-based findings we have. In research, objective is a core part of that. In teaching also, in methodology also, in strategies also, in techniques also, and even in model, without objective, it can't. So syntax is a chain of sequence. One is objective, second one is a syntax. Syntax means hierarchy. Hierarchy means a systematic gradation of particular content from lowest to the highest. How can we go? It is a hierarchy. That is the syntax, proper chain of event, chain of sequence of event. Suppose in method also we have a chain. If I taught for any classroom below 12 or in a higher education first grade, we have objective, we have a specification, then we have introductory part, we ask some question, take a feedback from that for the purpose where students are, what they know and what they want to know, where they are. For that purpose we have a preparative evaluation, that is the part. Means I qualify the syntax, that is the introductory part. Many times we won't say introduction, but it is a set induction. We induce that particular content in the classroom. That is the preparative part. It has the one. Second one, we have a statement topic. Today we are going to learn about the models of teaching or the description of learning or any accountancy topic or the title of your topic which you like to discuss today. Then it should be clear cut one. Even in one model, one teacher says that there is no need of any preparative questions. The teacher should join into the classroom and immediately say what he is going to taught in the class. It is actually another one notion which changed the syntax. One of our teacher asked to us, sir, is it necessary to follow the syntax, that is the hierarchy, systematic gradation of one to another? He asked me, why can't we won't give the assignment at the very outset and then begin the topic? Actually, it is the reverse one notion, but syntax qualifies the logical chain of a student. Then we have a statement of aim, what we actually teach in the classroom, then actual presentation. Presentation, we have a relia, teaching aid, some links are there, videos are there, audios are there, pictures are there, some three-dimensional charts are there, flashcards are there. So all the teaching aid which is helpful to learn, that is the inside the presentation. And after it qualifies the then presentation, we have a recapitulation of the main points, as like a news. Today's news in recapitulation of the main points or the headlines. So in many subjects, there is a no recapitulation of the main points. Instead of that, the syntax is student practice. What we learn today, and for that purpose, what kind of a practices should be conduct inside the classroom. Actually, it is the classroom assignment, not the home assignment. Classroom assignment, that is the classroom practices. In language, generally, we have the classroom practices. In social sciences and science, there is an experimentation. So they are discussing about the findings or the result. And in social sciences, they discuss the issues, social issues. So that is the student practice. What's your opinion about the Gram Panchayat election? That is the part of teaching in a student practice phase. It has the syntax. I'm qualifying the word syntax. Then we have the, after completion of that particular, we have asking some question, which is based on our teaching. That is the summative evaluation, 2 to 3 to 5 to 6 question. It has the many format. Some online questions are there, offline teach in the classroom also. Teacher asks, a student asks some question for a purpose of feedback or particular clarification of the content. It is also a part of that. And then we have an assignment. That is the last one step. In between that, there is a chalkboard writing, blackboard writing, or showing the PPTs, and all these happens as like a kitchen work. So syntax shows entry, right from entry to the teacher or exit to the classroom, exit of teacher from the classroom, what happens? It is a syntax, and it is a, on paper. Teacher enter into the class, ask the student to stand up and say, good morning, sir. The student says, good morning, teacher. So this is also mentioned on the paper. So it is the syntax, and it is in our teacher education program, this it has the notion. So syntax. Models of teaching focuses on the syntax, in which way, what are the steps to be followed for teaching. The third one point in your PPT, we have find the social system. Inside the classroom, the word social is not parallel to the society. Our social atmosphere is the student-teacher relationship, which is our society, our student, teacher-student relation. What happens actually in the classroom in that system is called a social system. Every institution have a DNA in their own. You people might be agree or may not be. But suppose I'm in a cyber institute. Cyber institute has its own DNA, Yojakastra Durlava. They have the planet. So cyber institute have its own DNA. Every family has its own DNA. Every institution have, as like a person have its own DNA. So I am from the government. Government system is a huge one. 4 lakh people are working in a government setup. I am one of that. I am belonging to one of that. It has a huge, huge type of a DNA structure. So it is called a social system. In which type of a social system students are being to belong? It has the system. Actually, in model, what type of a social system is needed to learn that? That is the social system. Getting? Then, are you with me? Then we have a support system. What type of a support we needed? Infrastructural system, learning resources, libraries, laboratories, broadband, then well-known qualified IT experts, all that is needed to conduct one FDP. How many human resources, technological resources, infrastructural resources, institutional resources, all it is in a support system. So every model needed a support system. Some models, as like a jurisprudential model, needed a support system from judiciary one. Suppose I like to learn about a member of parliament, how parliament works. Then call to the any former member of parliament and how it works. It needed a social support system from your society. So that is the support system. Student participation itself is a support system. How students are willing to do that activity is a support system. If they are not, how patient are responding to the doctor, to the medicine? Doctor says the patient is not supporting to, he is not viable to particular that medicine. So patient doesn't have a patience. Many dentists have say, open your mouth for half an hour. Then the patient is not ready to say for half an hour, then doctor says the patient needed a patience. The patient doesn't have. So today I am not clear his tooth pain because of the patient doesn't have a patience. So the support of the patient is needed to the doctor. As parallel to that, the teacher needed a support to the by the student, by the institution, by the society, by the management, by the principal, or many more things. A support system for each and every model. Then principles of reaction. How we react. How we react. In Marathi, it is called a pratikriyachi tatve. This is a difficult one as compared to the principle of reaction. But principles of reaction means for each and every model, it is supposed reaction program. How students should react for that. And his reaction is being calculated to know what he know, and some reactions are calculated what he don't know. So knowing area, unknowing area, dark area. So that four quadrant model, here we have find the principle of reaction. So how they react to particular principle principle of a model, their behavioral pattern is getting defined, and principles of reaction is being predefined in each and every model. Then its application. Many time application, the word application here related to the implications also. What are the implications of that particular model is being defined here in this component. So each and every model, in 22 model, these six steps are compulsory one. Without following these six steps, no model can work: objective, syntax, social system, support system, principles of reaction, and application of that particular model. Then next one, we have known the families. Already I have mentioned, but inside that particular family, what is interwoven in that? Let us learn the families of the models of teaching. One is information processing. The title itself clear. What is information? How it is being processed for the well-being of a student. Inductive, we know udgami. First there is a rule, and there is a then first there is an example, then there is a rule, and rule signifies another one example. So inductive, Hilda Taba has invented that particular steps. In inductive thinking model, I already mentioned in my previous part that it gives a new knowledge, newness of a knowledge. If I like to learn something new, then I follow the induction, knowing unknown part to known part to unknown part. Then we have Joseph Scrapp's one model, scientific inquiry model. Scientific inquiry, suppose I am presenting the PPT and light is off immediately, what should then I'm discommunicate with you, then I'm thinking, if I think scientific, what is the cause? The light may go off. My laptop have some technical barriers problems. In my pen drive also, it may happen some viruses. The whole city, Kolhapur city, doesn't have a light for 4 days. It might be a cause. Then there is a fuse is not working in Cyber Institute properly. Then it has an inquiry. Means what this is, why this is happening. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 reasons are there, and which one is reason is reasonable, how I am reaching up to the right reason, that is the scientific inquiry. Scientific inquiry of that, Joseph Scrabb has developed the scientific inquiry. Those who are right one, those who are able to reach the rightest cause in a shortest time, he know the scientific inquiry. Many two-wheeler experts, they just start the vehicle and says that sir, there is a problem in this particular choke or lever or lever cord or in any place. He has the sound learning that particular, he has internalized the problem in his mind and immediately find the solution. He touch such a places where there is a problem. It is called a development of your inquiry. And if you are finding many more solutions which are irrelevant one, if you lead from relevancy to irrelevance, means Joseph Schwab says you are not thinking scientifically. Okay. Then we have a concept attainment model. Jerome Bruner, Jacqueline Goodnow, and George Osteen. These are the three thinkers. They have found the concept attainment model. So how can we get the concept? Some terms are there, some concepts are there, some teaching points are there. How I reach there? So here Jerome Bruner stated, give some negative example which are not qualified that particular word. Make some positive sentences, some negative sentences which are not related to that. Some are related to that, some are not related to that. So find out some related sentences and reach up to the concept which is in my mind. I'm not teaching that concept. The concept is in my mind. Just I'm making some sentences which are positively skewed. I'm making some sentences which are totally negatively skewed. Some sentences which are combination of all these, some positive and negative sentences. It is in sentence form. So find out which one is positive and what will be in my mind. So that is the concept, attainment of concept. Not getting the concept, understanding the concept, attainment of concept. The Jerome Bruner, another one thinker, Jacqueline Goodnow, George Osteen. George Osteen has stated, the attainment of a concept is only when possible, when student is able to think diversely. Convergent thinking and divergent thinking. If he is divergently think what the teacher in his mind, then the George Osteen has stated the attainment of concept will be easily possible. So the people who are working in a social life, the strong social memory, they have the nice conception of how society works. There is a one quotation. We every day we read a newspaper and some politicians has stated some adverse news are there, and they read that and quote that public memory is neither public, public opinion is neither public nor opinion. They just read, make some comment and forget, or ever, may not, maybe. So that is the notion. They know how public memory works. So social memory, socially disordered memory, they have the conceptual understanding of society, caste, creed, religion, notion, all the ethnicity, all that background they know, and that is the conceptual framework is so strong, they know what is the social, Indian social structure, that is the socialistic pattern of society, and that is their knowing of the concept. So clarification of concept. As far as the content clarification is there, there are some many concepts. Learning means know the concept very well. So understanding of particular concept in a context of a situation, that is the concept. Then advanced organizer model. Actually, it is adverse to the another one model. Other all model, 21 models. Advanced organizer model, which is developed by David Asube, based on the theory of lecture method. Asube stated that many innovation says that students should be active in the class, they should be joining in the teacher in a discussion, they should participate in the playing all that games which is developed, educational games developed in the by the teacher, and in a lecture method students are generally sitting in the class and listening only, and they are not active at all. So this, all my four sentences being erased by David Asube. He says that in an advanced organizer model, lecture method is the best method of teaching. No doubt at all. He proclaimed many times, because what you consider that you people are just 200 people are just listening to Mr. Mane and they are passive one. No, not at all. They are active one. They are not just listening. They have the reflection on that particular word and activity is going on. Just it is not a psychomotor form, but in a bicognitive mind, by affective domain, both the domains are being worked there. So David Asubel stated, lecture method is the best one. So many times activity based, computer assisted, prolonged, all that methods, 21 models, they signifies different one notion. But why models are being important? Because some models are being developed only for lecture method. Suppose I like to teach particular poem Pehchan in Hindi for class, BA class, graduation class, at up to graduation level. So I should be present in the class, not by online as like today's teaching. I should be in front of them and should proclaim the poem in such a way that student should appeal that particular. Otherwise, the intention of teaching that poem is going to get defeated. I'm quite sure about this one. Because the poetry should be caught in the same way, not to be taught. In between lines, the meaning of the poem, some words are there where I don't know the meaning of that particular word, but I understood. I can enjoy. I like to quote here one example, Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening. That is a very popular poem. Pandit Nehru has put that particular poem in front of his table. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd of hosts. That is the daffodil poem. And Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening, another one poem, that woods are lovely, dark and deep, and I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep. That poem, if I like to quote online, then it doesn't have any effect. I consider so. If teacher, full body of the teacher, the teacher mouth is not only speaking, but the whole body is being communicated for that poem, and students are, their mind, their brain, their eyes, their ears, their nose, and all five sense organs are match the line. So teaching should not be shouldn't be an online teaching in that sense. We can give information through online, but insertion of a knowledge, acquisition of a knowledge, manifestation of a knowledge is only possible when teacher, actual teacher, is in front of them. Their mind is being connected with the student, their eyes is being matched with the student, and the there is a reciprocal in between relations, and teaching is happen when teacher is actually in front of them. If I insert the information, like to insert the information, use the online method for 1,000 people. So advanced organizer qualifies that lecture method is the best for, especially for poetry teaching. Suppose here I quote one poem, Pehchan, by Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. Very nice poem, very popular poem. And online, I'm not seeing to you, you people are not seeing to me, and I'm speaking that particular poem, and just imagine whether it has impacted or not on you or not. Ped ke upar chada aadmi uncha dikhai deta hai, jad mein khada aadmi nicha dikhai deta hai. Aadmi na uncha hota hai na nicha hota hai, na bada hota hai na chota hota hai, aadmi sirf aadmi hota hai. Pata nahi इस सीधे सपाट सत्य को दुनिया क्यों नहीं जानती, और अगर जानती है तो मन से क्यों नहीं मानती. इससे फर्क नहीं पड़ता कि आदमी कहां खड़ा है, पथ पर या रथ पर, तीर पर या प्राचीर पर. फर्क इससे पड़ता है कि आदमी जहां खड़ा है या जहां उसे खड़ा होना पड़ा है, वहां उसका धरातल क्या है, व्हाट इज द फाउंडेशन. हिमालय की चोटी पर पहुंच, एवरेस्ट विजय की पताका फेरा कोई विजेता, यदि ईर्ष्या से दग्ध अपने साथी से विश्वासघात करे, तो क्या उसका अपराध इसीलिए क्षम्य हो जाएगा कि वह हिमालय की चोटी पर उतरा था? जी नहीं, अपराध अपराध ही रहेगा. हिमालय की सारी धवलता उस काली मां को नहीं ढक सकती, कपड़ों की दुधिया सफेदी जैसे मन की मलिनता को नहीं छिपा सकती. किसी संत कवि ने कहा है कि मनुष्य के ऊपर कोई नहीं होता, लेकिन मनुष्य के ऊपर उसका मन होता है. छोटे मन से कोई बड़ा नहीं होता, टूटे मन से कोई खड़ा नहीं होता. इसीलिए तो भगवान कृष्ण को शस्त्रों से सज रथ पर चढ़े, कुरुक्षेत्र के मैदान में खड़े अर्जुन को गीता सुनानी पड़ी. मन हार कर मैदान नहीं जीते जाते, न मैदान जीतने से मन जीते जाते. चोटी से गिरने से अधिक चोट लगती है, अस्थि जुड़ जाती, पीड़ा मन में सुलगती है। इसका अर्थ यह नहीं कि चोटी पर चढ़ने की चुनौती ही न माने, इसका अर्थ यह भी नहीं कि परिस्थिति पर जय पाने की न ठाने। आदमी जहां है वही खड़ा रहे, दूसरों के दया के भरोसे पर पड़ा रहे, जड़ता का नाम जीवन नहीं है, पलायन पुरोगमन नहीं है। आदमी को चाहिए कि वह झूंझे, परिस्थितियों से लड़े, एक स्वप्न पड़े तो दूसरा गढ़े, किंतु कितना भी ऊंचा उठे मनुष्यता के स्तर से न गिरे, धरातल को न छोड़े से न मरे। एक बार धरती पर रख कर ही हमने आकाश पाताल को जीता है, धरती यह सब धारण करती है, कोई इस पर भार न बने, मिथ्या अभिमान से न तने। मनुष्य की असली पहचान उसके धनी आसन से नहीं होती, उसके न से ही होती है, और मन की फकीरी पर कुबेर की संपदा भी होती है। दिस इज द पोएम, सच अ लॉन्ग पोएम। इफ आई लाइक टू टॉक दिस पर्टिकुलर पोएम इन द क्लास ऑनलाइन, व्हाट विल हैपन? आई एम नॉट सीइंग देयर, स्टूडेंट्स आर ओपनिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑडियो एंड दे वॉक एंड दे आर नॉट कॉन्सर्ट। सो कंडीसिव एटमोस्फियर फॉर टीचिंग पर्टिकुलर पोएम, क्रिएटिंग द एटमोस्फियर, is needed. And David Asubel signifies that advanced organizer model signifies the lecture method, which is the best. So, such type of a model is being there. And last one, we have a cognitive growth model. Cognitive growth model by Jean Piaget. In a cognitive growth model, Jean Piaget has developed cognitive development. Memory model. I have more than. Then personal family model have non-directive, that is Carl Rogers, which is not directional. It has the step synaptics, means how we reach up to our solution. Classroom meeting model by William Glaser. Then some social families are there. Group investigation model, how we commencing together and find the solution. That is the group investigation by John Dewey. A role-playing model by the Fanny Schaffel, means playing the role, specifically designed a role, we change the role and understand the social situation. There is maybe a dowry death situation or corruption or some social issues are there where role-playing model, we play the role of sarpanch and member of the all that village development committee, and in the classroom atmosphere we play the role. It is not parallel to the simulation model. So it is different one. Social simulation, we play act in actual situation. Actually, I am in that particular place. So social simulation model by Siren, he has developed the social simulation model. In role playing, the dialogues are not predefined, but in social simulation model, the dialogues are predefined. So in a behavioral pattern model, we have contingency management model by B.F. Skinner. He's a psychologist. Self-control model, that is for changing my behavior. That self-awareness model, understanding the self, by B.F. Skinner model. Stress reduction model, model by D-centric one. Desensitization model means we have the phobia. Phobia of water, phobia of snake, phobia of a crowd, phobia of technophobia. So in desensitization model, we change that particular. So in a jurisprudential model, we related to the judiciary one, thinking inductively. We just discuss about that. And some memorization model, I'm quite... So personal family model have a focus on person, that is individual one, and individual leads to the society. So understanding the self, modeling restates of the group. Behavioral system model, changing in the behavior. If we like to change the student's behavior, then so these are near about 22 models, which is not being covered within 19 to 25 minutes. So just I focused on these particular, and due to the time constraint today, I shall stop here. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Now I will have a request to the participants. You can ask one or two questions because time is not available. Any questions to the participants? Please make it fast. I thought you have one or two questions. I think sir has made the topic very simple. So I think there is no question from the participants. So I will go ahead with the sir. Putting for those of thanks to the manager. Manager has demonstrated how exactly to enter the class by having the conducive environment. Few points I'd like to mention regarding the presentation in this particular models of the teaching. Sir has explained various learning and teaching techniques, and he has touched around 22 models of teaching. He has discussed various families of the models. Then he has given the characteristics of the models and teaching models. Very important for the budding teachers and for teachers like us. How to prepare the instruction material. Those who are not involved in that, they will get the guidance, so they will have to come from it. Then, most interesting is how to have a teacher-student interaction in the class format, how it is important for the effective teaching. So, I will explain it very nicely. And, due to lack of time, so we have to wind the party. But the point sir has raised is how to enter in the class with certain objectives. Because it is seen that teachers go to the class without any objective, but how it is not serving the purpose of teaching. Sir has explained it very nicely. So, sir, thank you very much for sharing your valuable time and sharing your experience with the participants and all of us. We are expecting to find cooperation in the future also. And I have one announcement. Before I close the session, I have one announcement for the participants. The next session will begin sharp at 12:15. So all of you can have a break of 2 minutes and request to join at 12:15. Next speaker, this person is ready, very eager to share the things with you. Thank you one and all. Thank you, sir, once again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay.